Hosko Dazzlers! Welcome back to Daz Games, another Daz Watches talk shows. They are very interesting, aren't they? Audiences gather, they pay tickets to simply watch people's lives falling apart. Fighting, screaming, relationships ending, people finding out they're not the father. Sometimes they're happy, sometimes they're not. Either way, I've never really been a fan of talk shows. But money's money, views are views, you know? And we'll do anything to get that, even if we film, you know, the odd dead body once in a while. But nonetheless, you guys wanted me to watch more Dr. Phil cases and you sent me this one. Let's watch a video!
My behavior is pretty bad. Violence, physical abuse, verbal abuse. On a scale of 1 to 10, I would think my anger would be 10. Trust me, when that happens, you do not want to be in my room.
I don't want to be in your room anyway. Why would I want to be in your room? That'd be weird, huh? Just Daz standing in the corner of the room like...
One time, I got really angry. I jumped off my bed and I pushed my mom. And it really hurt her back.
That's not that bad, is it? You know? You pushed your mum. I think I pushed my mum once. I got a mum slap for that one. That's not bad! Just pushed her mum.
Call my dad stupid, idiot, moron, dumb.
Really? Really? Daniela Broglie has a record deal now. For worse.
If my brothers and my sisters do something annoying, they're in big trouble.
I don't really see... I don't really see the big deal, okay? This is just a stroppy kid, all right? Doing a lot of pushing, huh?
I'll hurt them. I'll threaten. One time, they made me really angry. And I chased my siblings around with a knife.
All right, yeah, that is next level. Okay, all right. That you took it there. All right, you started down here with the normal shit, all right? Then you went with knives, okay? We've gone up a level. Jesus, she's leveled up. Oh my God!
When I was 6, I had a hamster named Jack.
What do you mean you had a hamster? Tell me you sold it in a garage sale!
One time I took him out of his cage. I wanted to play doctor.
With a hamster?! It's a veterinarian! Why am I correcting her?
Late and basically beat it to death into a flat object.
She beat her hamster to death with and made it a flat object. Christ, I thought this girl wasn't the real deal. She's killing hamsters.
Did you smash it?
Oh my God. I remember where I did it. It was in the living room.
Was he smashed?
Yeah, he was gone.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, this girl's on Dr. Phil. She should be on Dr. Phil. She should be in Arkham Asylum or something.
Another time, Mom showed us baby birds. I said, oh, they're so cute.
What did you do to the baby birds? The baby birds, what did you do to them?
5 minutes later, had a bunch of baby birds in my hands. And then that's when I remembered, if I put them back in the nest, the mama bird would kill them.
Don't take them out then!
The voices told me if I don't save the baby birds, then they're gonna do something to my family, something bad.
Did she just say the voices? What voices?
So I killed them.
Okay, let me get this straight. You took the baby birds out of the nest. Why? Who knows? Okay, the voices told you to save them. Because if you put them back in the nest, the mum's gonna be like, shit, you don't smell how I left you. So now I'm gonna mess you up and kill you. So to save them from death, you killed them. Am I missing something?
Makes me feel comfortable. It's just a bad situation.
Just don't buy it, really. It's very put on. It feels like acting in a way. We'll try and find an update on this story afterwards. Let's keep watching.
The 12-year-old daughter, Ineska, looks very cute and innocent, but she holds our whole family in a constant state of crisis.
Stupid idiot!
Ineska is explosive, violent, aggressive. She lies, she steals, and she-
Let's smack her with an iPad! No, that's probably not the best way to do it, Daz. Just, you know, I don't always think sometimes, okay?
Doesn't respect authority.
Knock it off! Wow.
You're not taking me, so I don't care!
Vanessa feeds off of negative energy. None of us know when she's gonna blow.
She may hit her siblings, cut her hair. She has gone into my purse and stolen my bank card and gone on a shopping spree. Recently, she took matches, lit paper, and set a comforter on fire.
Tap dancing. Christ! She tried to burn the house down? I don't think this is a Dr. Phil episode. This kid needs, like, serious help. She's trying to burn the house down.
Absolutely do not know what she's going to do next. When Aneska was 6 years old, she killed our pet hamster with a metal flashlight.
Killed it with a flashlight? Oh my god. I thought it was a knife. Hit with a flashlight? How many hits do you have to take to be killed by a flatworm if you're a hamster? I guess it's a smaller thing. Jesus Christ.
He's a carpet by the time she was done. She was absolutely nonchalant about it.
When Aneska was 7, she went outside. She got into a bird's nest. She killed the baby birds.
Aneska took it upon herself to grab the baby birds, squeeze them till their eyeballs and popped out and her guts popped out. Aneska told me that the voices told her to do it.
I took her to the doctor.
Thank you. Finally, take her to the doctor immediately, now, before she gets hold of another bird.
We began antipsychotic medication. The voices did stop, but it didn't stop her outbursts.
Keep an eye on Aneska all the time. She's uncontrollable, very volatile.
Get away from me, you bitch!
We have a knife block set that we've had to lock up because Aneska chased her two siblings around with a...
When it gets to this point, like, I know you love your child, but if you have to lock up knives, okay, because she's gonna stab her brothers and sisters. I really just think that this is psychosis. She's hearing voices. This is psychotic. This is, you know, really bad. And I think taking her on Dr. Phil or any talk show is the worst thing you can do. Because it's not only going to be on TV for millions of people to watch and judge and post in and say, social media is a thing now, okay? And people aren't always kind. They are going to post everything. And the voices in their head already telling her, stab everyone. Now, just stab them all. And maybe Aneska's thinking, trying to avoid the voices, but when everyone, now she's been on the show and has had mass exposure and has got every dickhead out there messaging in saying all these cruel things about her, she's gonna start listening to those voices. This is why we have school shooters, people. And we all ask, what could we have done to avoid this situation? Deal with it while in a very, very healthy manner, very, very quickly. Nip it in the bud. God damn it. Don't bring him on Dr. Phil on a talk show. Honestly, it's madness. I don't know what's wrong with the world. This girl is clearly very, very messed up and needs help.
One time when Aneska shared a room with her sister, we heard screams coming from the room. We went running in to find Aneska choking her. We were terrified. We didn't know what was going on and why she would be doing this to her younger sister.
But the check we got from Dr. Phil, we could buy another child after she choked it. Come on! And this kid as well, I might add, all people forget, when they shoot these promos, what you're seeing now for the shows, they're getting her to stand in dark hallways and like, this is a child, if this is real, this is a child with deeply psychological issues. And this show, no matter how good Dr. Phil is, no matter how much he's helped people, I just think it's wrong. It's wrong, isn't it?
When we reprimanded her, she just laughed at us. It just sent chills through us.
My other kids are terrified of their sister. Everybody walks on eggshells for good reason.
We have taken Aneska to several doctors, been on over 35 different medications, admitted to our local child and adolescent treatment center 18 times. To this day, nothing has worked. If Aneska continues down this path, Aneska will either be dead or in jail. We don't have the answers. I feel completely helpless.
God, all those visitations and nothing's worked. I feel so bad for her. Like, you know, it's like she's obviously psychotic. Maybe borderline schizophrenic. What am I talking about? She's beyond that. I get that maybe they might feel out of options, but again, I just don't feel like a talk show like this is really gonna help.
Are you sorry that your brothers and sisters are afraid of you?
Yes.
Do you wish they were not afraid of you?
Yes.
but yet you attack them?
Yes.
Do you wish you could stop yourself from attacking them?
Yes. And why am I saying yes so much?
You tell me.
Oh, bless her heart. Honestly, I feel so bad for her. She clearly, some people, they suffer with such terrible states of psychosis that, like, there is no cure. Like, they're just mental. And it makes you think about her whole life, the rest of her future. Like, what is it going to be like?
You're asking me the yes questions?
Your sister wrote a letter. She said, the other day she got extremely mad at me talking about you and my brothers and started to hurt us. Aneska ended up hitting and scratching the babysitter. 5 minutes later, me and my brothers were in my room and Aneska tries to come in and hurt us, but we were holding the door. My babysitter comes in and tells her to draw the picture that we've already seen of what she was feeling. So she draws a picture of me and my brothers in graves. She wants us dead. I'm afraid to sleep at night. Please, can you help? Do you want them dead?
No. They're my siblings.
Enter me with a large pole. Oh my God. She's drawn this. Right, can you imagine being there for that one? Oh, lovely, sweetie. This one's going on the fridge. Holy shit. Honestly, wow. Why is this girl on a talk show? It's not going to help if they've been to so many different people. They need to go next level. Like, for the sibling safety as well. She's only going to get hold of something and then jab them and kill them. Like, I think she needs, like... Like, it sounds awful, but she needs some sort of care for her own safety and others. Like, there needs to be something other than a talk show that they could be doing right now.
I never want them dead. I don't want them dead.
Can you...
So she's already displaying, like symptoms of guilt there. She's aware that she's on a stage on the television show. Everyone's staring at her, judging her. Even though that might be something she was feeling at the time or something voices were telling her, to put her on this stage and make it feel like this is wrong. Obviously, it's wrong, but make her feel like she is just wrong and different. You're going to spur her the other way. Family should not have put her on this show. It's just awful. And everyone will leave comments about, like, how she's, you know, mental and be really cruel and mean. Like, there's people out there that just will be absolutely horrific to this girl.
Live with them?
Mm-hmm. I can live with them. But only on one occasion. Can you try and keep them away from me? Because they're very, very annoying.
And that's what we have to do at home.
Yeah.
Well, do our best to separate.
That's not going to work.
God bless America.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Wow. Okay, so everything else aside, I feel very bad for the girl. It's took like a really dark turn there at the end, didn't it? Jesus Christ. I feel that it's very hard for anyone with mental health to come forward and talk about it. And I feel that sometimes talk shows can help. But when you're dealing with such a young girl with such a fragile mind, exploiting it. And it is exploiting it. Like, it's a TV show. They dramatize it. They shoot promos about it. Make it all more dramatic. They put a musical score over it. Dr. Phil and the show are making a show about this. They're trying to get views from this, you know? I think there should just be a limit of psychosis that they should have on the show. I don't think a young girl like that in that state of mind belonged on a show like that. All I can hope is that, you know, maybe they actually got a breakthrough or something after the show. Like, maybe putting her on that platform, if it helped in any way, fine. I just don't know if it will. Mixed feelings. Mixed feelings after that one. Guys, thank you so much for sharing this video. I really would love an update on this. I'd love to know how she is. Like, love, caress my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Stay dazzling. Sick pick, I'ma click on there. There.